Handing over objects to robots, so-called human-to-robot handovers, are one of the most important tasks of human-robot interaction. In this paper, we introduce the first framework to learn human-to-robot handovers from vision input. Teaching robots to solve this task is challenging, because the robot needs to react to complex and dynamic human behaviours. Therefore, training human-to-robot handovers requires an accurate simulation of human behaviour. Recent work has introduced a simulation environment for benchmarking human-to-robot handovers. However, this environment has only been used for evaluation purposes and not for policy learning. In this paper, we leverage this environment to train handover policies by allowing the robot to interact with a human in the loop. Our overall pipeline consists of three main modules: perception, vision-based control, and the handover environment. The human hand mimics trajectories recorded from motion capture data. The goal of the robot is to grasp the object from the human and bring it back to a designated location. The robot has a wrist-mounted camera that renders RGBD images. These images are sent to the perception module. The perception module uses segmentation masks and the depth image to compute a segmented point cloud of the hand and object. The segmented point cloud is then sent to the vision-based control module. In the control module, the point cloud is passed through PointNet++, which computes a lower dimensional feature embedding. A control policy receives the feature and predicts actions, which are used to control the robot. A grasp prediction network takes the same feature embedding and decides whether the robot should stay in an approaching phase or transition into a grasping phase. In the approaching phase, the robot runs the policy continuously to move from an initial position to the human to find a pre-grasp pose close to the object. In the grasping phase, the robot simply moves the gripper forward, closes it, and brings the object back to a goal location. Our approach introduces a two-stage teacher-student training procedure. In the first stage, we assume that the human hand has come to a stop before the robot starts moving. We then collect expert demonstrations with an open loop motion and grasp planner. We also gather experiences with our RL agent. The experience transitions from the physics simulation are pushed into a replay buffer that will be used for training. In the second stage, we move to the more challenging setting where the human hand and the robot move at the same time. We cannot use open loop motion and grasp planning in this setting anymore. Therefore, we replace the expert motion and grasp planner with the pre-trained policy from the previous stage and freeze its networks. We also initialize the RL agent with the pre-trained networks. We now continue gathering experiences in the same fashion by filling a new replay buffer. We now present qualitative results. Related work cannot react to dynamic movement of the human. On the other hand, our method can react to human movement and avoid collisions. The baseline often tries to grasp the object in the most direct path. In our method, the robot gets close to the object. Then, it adjusts its end effector into a good pre-grasp pose from where the object can be grasped safely. We evaluate the transfer capabilities of our method and baselines by running tests with a different physics simulation engine. We find that the baseline struggles with transfer. It often misses the object completely. In contrast, our method transfers more robustly. We also transfer our method to a real system. In our pilot study, we found that our method leads to more successful grasps compared to the baseline. In our user study, a majority of participants favored our system over the baseline. Our approach struggles when the human moves too fast towards the robot. Due to noise in the real system, the robot does not always find a feasible grasp. In summary, we introduced the first framework that can be used to train human-to-robot handovers from point clouds. We introduce a two-stage teacher-student training procedure that can be used to train policies with a moving human in the loop. We demonstrate that our method generalizes to unseen motions. We show that our approach transfers to a different physics engine. We evaluated our method on a real system and found that it performs better than the baseline. Thanks for watching.